Hello dear students, welcome to Nyana Jyoti YouTube channel. In this video we are going to learn about the lesson Aruna Asaf Ali, the great patriot. Aruna Asaf Ali, known as the grand old lady of the independence movement, and she was fairy leader who plung headlong into politics at a time when the freedom struggle was raging. She was born into an orthodox Hindu Bengali family in 1909 at Kalka in Haryana. Aruna, she got married at the age of 19 to Asaf Ali, a prominent figure in the freedom struggle and 20 years a senior. Aruna Asaf Ali's first major political involvement was during the Salt Satyagraha, when she was addressed public meetings and led processions. She was prosecuted in Delhi, and on her refusal to furnish security for good behavior, was sentenced to 1 year imprisonment. A few months later, when most political prisoners were being released, she was not released until a public agitation was launched in her support. In 1932, she was again arrested and put in the Delhi jail, where she went on a hunger strike to protest against the callous treatment of political prisoners. Her demands were considered, but she was transferred to Ambala jail, where she was kept in solitary confinement. After her release, she stayed away from the movement for 10 years. Something significant happened in 1942. She attended the Bombay Congress session along with her husband, during which the Quit India resolution was passed on 8th August. The committee had planned the hoisting of the tricolour at Gwalior Tank Maidan, but the British got wind of the plan and arrested the top leaders including Gandhi ji a few hours before the event. The police knocked the door of Aruna Asaf Ali, and the police announced about Asaf Saheb's arrest. And Aruna asked what about hers, and police replied there was no warrant for her. The British sergeant, who had come in a taxi with a couple of policemen to let Aruna accompany them to the railway station to see of her husband. Aruna saw Mulanza Azad sitting at a window in a compartment of the special train and stopped to talk to him. As Congress president, he was to unfurl the tricolor at a public gathering at Gwalior Tank Maidan at 8 a.m. This decision to stand in for Mulanza Azhar was the beginning of a chapter of heroism and unrest in the life of Aruna Asaf Ali. Her narrative proceeds. Bulabhai Desai's son Dhirubhai had come to the railway station, and he drove Aruna in his car to the Maidan. The meeting was declared illegal under Section 144. A white-skinned sergeant gave 2 minutes for the crowd to disperse. Aruna quickly scrambled up to the dais, announced to the people the arrest of leaders, and pulled the cord to hoist the national flag. Hardly had the flag been unfurled when the police lobbed tear gas shells into the crowd. The men and the women ran helter-skelter with tears streaming down their cheeks. And the experience of that morning made Aruna decide that she would not again tamely enter jail by offering satyagraha. Aruna's act of defiance on August 9th virtually marked the start of the Quit India movement. She now became a full-time activist in the movement. Eventually going underground to avoid being arrested, she became the editor of Inquilab, the monthly magazine for the Congress, along with Ram Manohar Lohia. In the 1944 issue of the magazine, she advised freedom fighters not to allow any academic arguments on questions like violence and non-violence to divert attention from the stern realities of the day. In the meantime, the government announced a reward of Rs 5000 for Aruna's capture. She became ill, and on hearing this, Gandhiji advised her to surrender. However, Aruna surrendered only when the warrants for her arrest were cancelled on 26 January 1946. After India attained independence, Aruna Asafali turned to social work and helped to establish the National Federation of Indian Women in 1954. In 1992, she was awarded the Nehru Award for International Understanding. She breathed her last in July 1996. The country honored her with its highest civilian award, the Bharat Ratna, posthumously.
From Nanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.nanajyoti.com.